Well, Wolf, I can talk you through what happened last night. To be perfectly honest, I don't see how that could have been the case. There were about 40 journalists on the bus that the government organized, and it took some time to organize it after they said they wanted to go. We weren't exactly clear where we were going. We knew there'd been a strike close to the palace compound. We didn't know precisely that's where we were going. And it took perhaps over half an hour, 45 minutes, to sort of fight our way through the traffic there to get there, because there's so many cars outside that sort of palace compound area. All the Gaddafi loyalists were going there. But before the bus left the hotel, a couple of people wanted to get off. They got off the bus. They had no problem getting off the bus, even as it was sort of driving out the gates, last-minute changes of mind, changes of plan. Those people got off the bus. And there was no compunction on us to go and get on the bus. I mean, some journalists, Fox among them, chose not to go out on, not to go on the trip. Another group of journalists chose not to go on this particular trip. We'd chosen not to go out on a trip earlier in the day. You know, you're just, if you don't go, you're just ignored by the officials. They don't come banging on your door. So it took us about 45 minutes to get over there. When we got there, we got off the bus, put our bags through security. There's like an airport screening thing. You walk for 5 minutes, go through another security, wait for 5 minutes. Then we were taken through to the building that had been damaged and destroyed, and we had just about enough time to shoot everything that we wanted to shoot around that building, 15, 20 minutes. Then we were whisked away to the tent where Muammar Gaddafi sits, given about 3 minutes to grab a couple of hasty shots there, whisked out of the comp back through the security and back to our bus. And I was literally bundled, pushed on the bus while I was trying to be on the air broadcasting by a government official pushing me on the bus, trying to get us out of there. So my analysis is, and I've been doing this for many, many years, and we're very cognizant of the fact that maybe the government might try and pull stunts like that with journalists here, something you're very acutely aware of. But my sense of what happened was that wasn't what was happening. The time that we arrived there was quite a random time. We were in, we went, we were pretty quickly taken to where we were going, and pretty quickly they got rid of us. I think what they were taking us there for was to show us this building that had been hit, because they said the Pentagon spokesman had said no buildings in the compound would be hit. That's what they wanted to do, and then they got rid of us. And that's the way this government operates here. Wolf?
So just the bottom line, you don't believe that the Libyans were using you and your colleagues as human shields to prevent British jet fighters from attacking this site?
Wolf, we were at that compound for about 2.5 hours on the previous night, waiting there with about 1,000 Gaddafi supporters expecting Gaddafi to come out for a speech. We went there when we wanted to go. We left there when we wanted to leave. All the other journalists, when they wanted to leave, were able to leave as well. When we went last night to see this building that was bombed, we weren't kept hanging around there for half an hour or an hour, or told, no, you must wait a bit longer. No, you have to stay here. You can't leave. I think if somebody wanted to use us as a human shield, and of course they wouldn't know if the building was planned to be targeted, when it was planned to be targeted, if they wanted to use us as human shields, I believe, this would have been my suspicion and expectation, they would have kept us there for a lot longer. That's not what happened. And I think my perception of this is that any journalist who came along on the trip last night would share that experience and would see it from the same perspective. If people didn't go on that journey, as Fox didn't, then perhaps they would have a different perspective. But I think if they'd been there to witness it themselves, they would have seen how it played out.